Dear students, today in this class we are going to learn first lesson in supplementary reading known as Narayanpura incident written by Shashi Deshpande. This story is all about how the people of Narayanpur participated in Quit India movement in the year 1942, and moreover it is a story about a teacher who participated in Quit India movement. So now I'm going to read the introduction part of this lesson. The year is 1942, the time of the Quit India movement. A teacher in a small town, a follower of Gandhiji, has been arrested. His elder son, 18-year-old Mohan, and his college friends, including Suman, believe in a different form of resistance to the British. His younger son, Babu, age 13, and daughter, Manju, 2 years younger, are also keen to participate in the struggle against the British. So, in this introduction, what can we learn is a teacher in a small town called Narayanpur, and he was the follower of Gandhiji. He was arrested by the British because he participated in Quit India movement or Quit India struggle. And thereby what happened, as he was arrested, that struggle in that town, Narayanpur, was continued by his son, who was 18 year old by name Mohan, and his friends, as well as one of his friends by name Suman, also participated in the struggle. But all these students believed in a different form of resistance against the British. And another son of the teacher by name Babu, who was 13 year old, and his daughter by name Manju, who was 11 year old, also wanted to participate in the struggle. So as we know that British had come to India for trade purpose, but afterwards they established their empire in India and they ruled us for so many years, and we got independence in the year 1947. So let us see how the people of this town continued the struggle which was started by the teacher in that small town Narayanpur. Here people means particularly the students, college going students, have participated in the Quit India movement. So therefore I am going to read the paragraphs and I am going to explain you the paragraphs. Now first two paragraphs. First paragraph: "Are you coming, Manju?" Babu asked. "Coming where?" said Manju. Even as the brother and sister were talking, they heard magical words. "They are coming, they are coming." The children, like others, rushed out, Heedless of the rain, policemen now appeared all along the road. Some of them walked in front of the students and some by their sides, but the students marched as if the police didn't exist. They walked in complete silence. There were no slogans, no shouts, just the shuffle of feet, the drip of rain, and a low murmur from the watching crowd. Babu and Manju looked eagerly for Mohan. Yes, there he was, dressed in a white pajamas and cream colored shirt, with another boy, both holding aloft a picture of the Mahatma. Okay, they are the first two paragraphs. In the first paragraph, let us see what it is written. Are you coming, Manju? Babu asked. See, a small discussion is going on. A small conversation is going on between Manju and
Babu.
Babu and Manju were discussing. Manju was the daughter of the teacher and Babu was the second son of the teacher. Babu asked Manju, are you coming? So now Manju asked, coming where? Said Manju. Even as the brother and sister were talking, they heard magical words. They are coming, they are coming. So now Manju and Babu were discussing. Babu asked Manju, are you coming? So at that time Manju asked Babu, coming where? Where to? Go now. So by that time, as brother and sister were talking, at that time both brother and sister heard some magical words. They are coming means who are coming? Who shouted these words? The students who are on the roads. The students who are on the road, who participated in the Quit India movement. So they shouted that they are coming. So they are coming means policemen were coming. So the children, like others, rushed out heedless of the rain. So as other children went outside to see the police, the same way both Babu and Manju went out of the house, rushed out of the house to see the policeman. Heedless of the rain, it was raining, even then they didn't care for rain, they went outside. Policeman now appeared, policeman came there, all along the road in the town. So they were standing. Some of them walked in front of the students, some by their sides. The students who participated in Quit India movement stood there, and the policemen who had come to that place, they went in front of the students, and other policemen went by the side of the students. But the students who participated in Quit India movement, they were marching as if that there were no policemen at all. They walked in complete silence. How did the students participated in the Quit India movement? They walked silently. There were no slogans. No slogans were there. They didn't shout any slogans. and they did not shout at all, just the shuffle of feet. So what can you hear at that time? You can hear the shuffle of a rain, shuffle of a feet, the drip of rain, and low murmur from the watching crowd. So people were watching the students. Policemen were there. So the students who participated in the Quit India movement walked silently. Babu and Manju looked eagerly for Mohan. Yes, there he was, dressed in white pyjamas and cream colored shirt, with another boy holding a loft of picture of the Mahatma. So Manju and Babu had come outside the house. They were eagerly looking for their brother Mohan, and they saw their brother was standing there wearing a white pyjama and a cream colored shirt, with another boy holding the picture of a Mahatma Gandhiji. So both Mohan and another boy, they held the picture of a Mahatma Gandhiji. Third paragraph, their arms must have ached holding it up that way for so long, but their faces were expressionless. Now the leaders of the procession, Suman was one of them, they saw in excitement, had reached the barricades. A police officer, he was the DSP, Mohan told them later, came up to them. There was some conversation between him and the students. The students seemed to be arguing. The rain had lessened now, and the police officer took off his hat and ruffled his hair. Once he laughed, showing all his teeth, but the students remained serious. One of them had him a piece of paper. He took it without glancing at it and nodded. The students turned their backs on him, and one of them shouted, "Mahatma Gandhi Ji Ki Jai!" The others shouted back loudly, and then they briskly marched back the way they had come. So, third paragraph, both Mohan and another boy, they held the picture of Mahatma Gandhi Ji. So, for holding that picture for a long time, they might have suffered a pain in their arms. But their faces were expressionless. You could not see any kind of expression in their faces. Now, the leader of the procession, Suman, was one of them. Suman was one of the leaders of that procession. They saw in excitement, had reached the barrier gates. So, Suman reached the barrier gates. A police officer, he was the DSP, Mohan told them later, came up to them. So, the policeman whom the leader met, he was the DSP. So, Mohan told about this to Manju and Babu later on. There was some conversation between him and the students. So, DSP and students had a conversation, a small conversation. The students seemed to be arguing. The students argued with the DSP. Rain had lessened. So now the rainfall was stopped, and the officer took off his hat and ruffled his hair. He ruffled his hair like this. Once he laughed, showing all his teeth, he laughed at the students, but the students remained serious. The students were very serious. One of them handed him a piece of paper. One student gave the DSP a piece of paper. He took it without glancing it and nodded. So the DSP took the piece of paper that was given by the student, and he did not see anything. He did not read. The students turned their backs on him, and one of them shouted. So as the DSP did not respond to the students for the letter that was given by them, okay, they were very angry, and they came back, and one of them shouted, Mahatma Gandhi ji ki jai, Mahatma Gandhi ji ki jai. The others also shouted, followed him, and walked briskly. Fifth paragraph. Is that all? Manju asked in disappointment. What else did you want? A dance? A drama? Babu asked scornfully, nervously. He understood her feeling and asked Mohan the same question when he returned home. Why did you go back so quietly? Were you scared of what the police would do? Mohan seemed immensely pleased with himself. Scared? Not in the least. We had planned it this way. We knew they would stop us. They wanted us to do that so that they could not bear us up and haul us away to Jai. But we were not prepared to go to Jai, not as such. Anyway, not until we have given them much more trouble. And so we decided we would give them no chance at all. What was the point then? Babu asked, while Manju listened earnestly, her chin cupped in her hands. It's like a declaration of war. We have told them this is war for us and you are the enemy. You don't start a war without first declaring your intentions, do you? So now, what happened in the union? Okay, the union. Is that all? Manju asked in disappointment. So, Babu told about the incident, what had happened there on the road. So, for that, Manju's reply was, is that all? Only that much? She was in disappointment. Now, Babu was somewhat angered. And what did he ask? What else did you want? A dance or a drama? Other than that, what do you want? Do you want a dance or drama? Babu asked Manju. But he was also feeling the same what was felt by Manju. Therefore, he asked the same question to Manju. So he asked Mohan, Babu asked Mohan, why did they go back so quietly? Well, you scared of what the police would do. So Babu asked Mohan, why did they go back so quietly when the police officer DSP didn't give any response to the letter, okay, to them for giving that letter? What, they were afraid, scared of the policeman? Now Mohan seemed immensely pleased with himself. Scared? Mohan was pleased and said, scared? Not in the least. No. We were not afraid of the police. We had planned it this way. So now Mohan is explaining actually what their plan was against the British policeman. So Mohan is explaining all the details regarding the struggle, the protest, to Babu. He said that they were not at all afraid of the policeman, but they planned their protest in that way. We knew they would stop us at the gate. So we were knowing that the policeman would stop us at the gate. We knew they expect us to protest and be violent. We knew about the police that police wanted us to be violent and police wanted us to be protest, because they wanted us to do so. The police wanted us to protest them and to be violent. They wanted this from us. Why? Because they wanted to beat us and they wanted to take us to jail. So Mohan explained clearly to Babu that the police wanted these students who participated in the struggle, okay, to be protest, to be violent, so that the policeman can arrest them. Okay, but the students who participated in the struggle, they didn't give any chance to the police to arrest them, because they had it, they planned it in that way only. They didn't want the police to arrest them in any manner, in any way. Not until we have given them much more trouble, and so we decided we would give them no chance at all. So Mohan told Babu that they planned, okay, their struggle in that way, and the policeman, okay, who wanted to arrest them, for them they didn't want to give any chance to arrest the students. What was the point then? Babu asked. Okay, even then, what was your main intention? While Manju listened earnestly, her chin cupped in her hands. So Manju was sitting beside them. She was listening to them very eagerly. So it's like a declaration of war. So our intention is to declare war on the police. We have told them, we have told the police that we are going to declare war. This is war for us and you are the enemy. We have told the police it is our war and you are the enemy. You don't start a war without first declaring your intentions, do you? So Baba asked, you don't start your war without giving your declarations. Seventh paragraph now. Unless you are Adolf Hitler, Amma, who had been quietly listening to them, said with a small smile. So now Amma said that without declaring your intentions, don't declare war unless you are Adolf Hitler. So who had been quietly listening to them said with a smile. Right, which we were not. So that how it was and what was that paper you gave the policeman? That was a notice served on the collector as a representative of His Majesty's government, asking them to quit India or face the consequences. So now mother of Mohan was asking, what was the paper that you gave to the policeman, DSP? So thereby Mohan said to his mother that they have served a notice to the collector who was the representative of His Majesty's government, asking him to quit India or to face consequences. So in that letter it was written, it was a notice to the collector who was the representative of Majesty's government, British Majesty's government, that immediately they have to leave India or else they have to face the consequences. Suman and another boy turned up there up after they had finished their dinner that night. The boy staggered in with a large newspaper covered parcel in his hands. Got it? Mohan asked. His voice tense with excitement. Yes, lot of trouble though. Where shall I take it? Here, let me help you. My room.
Okay, Amma.
No, I think the puja room is better. A light there will look more normal. Right, as usual, Amma. The puja room. Then the boy went away after a whispered conversation with Suman. Then Suman, Amma and Mohan went into the small puja room. Babu and Manju stared curiously over their shoulders at the mysterious parcel which turned out to be cyclostylic machine. So, as Mohan and his mother were talking to one another at that time, Suman and another boy. Suman was the leader of the struggle, protest. Suman and another boy, after having their dinner, they came to the house of Mohan with a large parcel. That parcel was covered with the newspaper. So he was holding that parcel like this and came to Mohan's house. So now, as soon as Mohan saw them, he asked, Got it? His voice was, okay, in excitement. Yes. Another boy who was holding the parcel said, yes, with a lot of trouble. So it was a lot of trouble. Even then, we brought it. Where shall I take it? Where shall I keep that parcel? The boy asked. Here, let me help you. My room. So Mohan told, let us keep it in my room. I'll help you. Okay, Amma. No, I think the puja room is better. A light there will look more normal. Right? As usual, Amma. So now, Amma told them to keep it in puja room because it was the better place. It was the better place and the light there, it was normal. So therefore, puja room was quite better for them to keep that parcel. So after keeping that parcel there in the puja room, that boy who had come with the Suman went away. Now Suman, Mohan and mother, they were discussing seriously. And the parcel which was brought, it was cyclostylic machine, printing machine. It was printing machine. On the other hand, Manju and Babu, they were looking at the parcel so curiously. Ninth paragraph. Babu, Mohan said as they settled down to work, sit out in the front room and keep watch. Give us a warning if anyone seems to be coming to our house. Manju, go to bed or else. He went on, noticing her crestfallen face. You sit here in the hall and pass on Babu's warning to us. 10th paragraph. Babu sat outside, alert and attentive. He felt a thickening in his throat. It was beginning, and at last he was doing something. What a pity Gaupya, Murali and others would never know about, perhaps. Someday He checked himself and kept his eyes and mind on the road outside. It was deserted. In a little while, the 9 o'clock siren went off. Babu thought for the first time that a day of the war being fought all over the world. And suddenly, coming out of his reverie, he tensed. A man riding a bike got off and stopped right outside their gate, but it was only a light to light a cigarette, it seemed. Babu could see the match flaring, then the glow in front of the man's face. The small point of light moved as if the man got on his back and rode away. One more bike. Babu flung himself inside. Manju turned a starlit face to him. Someone is coming in. Now, in Mohan's house, Suman was there, Mohan was there, Mohan's mother was there, and Manju and Babu were there. So now, Mohan asked Babu to sit outside the front room and to watch and to tell or to give him warning about the people who'd come to their house. So Mohan told Babu to keep watch on the people who would come to their house. And on the other hand, Mohan asked Manju to go to bed, but she had curious to know about what was going on. So therefore, Mohan told Manju to sit in the hall and to pause all the warnings that were given by Babu to them. So now Manju's work is to pass on the warnings of Babu to Mohan. Now Babu sat outside the room, was barely alert and attentive. He felt a thickening in his throat. He felt some kind of irritation in his throat. It was the beginning. It was started. And at last he was doing something. And he felt that for the first time the war was going to occur. In the meanwhile, as it was 9 o'clock, the siren went off and there was total silence. And at that time, Babu felt that for the first time the war is going to occur. And suddenly he saw a man riding a bike, and he got down in front of the Mohan's house. After getting down from the bike, he got down to lit a cigarette, and at that time he saw the face of that man. And after that, that man went away from that place. Afterwards, another bike came there, and Babu saw it and ran away into the house and told that someone was coming there.